If Minnesota public defenders follow in the footsteps of Minneapolis teachers and go on strike, it will make history. But both sides say it's still avoidable.
They haven't had a strike here in Minnesota. We don't want to have a strike here in Minnesota. You know, we want the public defense system to continue to provide the services to the communities that they represent.
Leaders from Teamsters Local 320, which represents about 700 public defenders and staff in Minnesota, will know tomorrow whether a strike is at least on the table.
I won't be surprised.
State Representative Jamie Becker Finn has been listening to public defenders pleading for help, addressing staffing shortages, working conditions, and growing backlogs throughout the past few months.
We are exhausted. The pandemic and the backlog have illuminated problems brewing for years.
My clients, our most vulnerable citizens, primarily children of color, bear the brunt and the real cost.
The Board of Public Defense has a retention and recruitment problem resulting from low pay and working conditions that are directly impacting our clients.
The Board of Public Defense says it will take 149 more attorneys plus 112 more support staff just to bring Minnesota to the national standard for public defender caseloads. And Becker Finn is pushing legislation to fully fund that for the first time with $50 million from the state surplus.
Unlike the vast majority of things in our state budget, it is constitutionally required that we do this, and we have failed to do it forever.
In a statement, the Board of Public Defense agreed that attorneys are understaffed and underpaid, but wrote, "We have fought for additional money to move the salary structure higher and to hire much-needed staff. However, the board is constrained in its budget and in negotiations by what is allocated from the legislature." But the union says economics are just part of the problem.
Things like remote work, that's non-economic. That doesn't have anything to do with the legislature.
You know, we're going through a period of the Great Resignation, and through a lack of leadership, the Board of Public Defense isn't doing anything to retain its current workforce.
To those watching at home, what kind of an impact would it have if there's a walkout or a labor stoppage when it comes to public defenders?
I mean, the impact would be incredible. I think, you know, the thing I always bring up for folks is that we all know somebody, a family member, a friend who at some point in their life has had to deal with the criminal justice system. And a lot of those people rely on public defenders. It would be incredibly disruptive to the courts and everybody sort of across the board.
And just to give you some perspective, the Board of Public Defense says public defenders handle about 150,000 cases in Minnesota every year. They also say that their last offer included pay raises that top 10% for the vast majority of staff. But as you heard, it's not just about the money, Jana.
Well, Kent, we know that we get the count of that vote tomorrow. Do all the public defenders in Minnesota actually take a vote tomorrow?
No, they've already voted. This is the counting and tabulation of those votes. We understand it'll happen sometime tomorrow afternoon.
All right. Thanks for getting us up to speed before we get that count result. Appreciate it, Kent.